This is Yvette, and this evening we're going to do a cabin, so let's get started. Okay, I have the supplies laid out here, and you can just pause the video if you want to copy them down. So I was doodling around before I started this painting and just sketching some different barns and cabins and stuff like that. It's kind of fun to do your own sketching and make up your own composition before you start a painting. And as you can see, I already have my background laid out. It's not spectacular, but it's something better than just a boring white canvas. So I've decided to put my little cabin right here, because I think that's a good spot. To start out, I'm just going to take my large knife, and you can use any kind of a knife that you have as long as it has a nice flat edge. I'm going to pull my paint out flat. I'm going to get a roll of paint. And what I want to do is start making my roof first. So I'm going to just lightly just put on some marks for my roof. And I always start the cabin the same way. I'm off to a really good start, aren't I? Oh well, that's all right. This is just for fun anyway. Okay, so we have our peak. And you notice this knife has similar kind of a peak. You can use it either way, right-handed or left-handed. This particular knife works out really good. So anyway, okay, so we have a peak. I want to take another roll of paint, and I'm going to just put a little more roof line. Just go right over that tree there, and I want to put a little bit here. Now you notice that this roof line is coming narrower as it gets towards the back. That's because there will be more distance. And again, a little tiny roll. When I say a little tiny roll, let me show you this. Pull the paint out flat, and if I say a little tiny roll, all I want you to do, I don't know if you can see this or not, put your knife straight on the board, pull a little bit, and go across. And that'll give you a very tiny roll. So then you just go ahead and touch there. And that's the perfect roof line. Okay, now we're going to continue. This time I want a bigger roll of paint. Let's start right here. This is going to be the front of the cabin. My sun is coming in from this way, so this will be the lighter side. But to start off, it's going to be all dark. So put your knife in, touch, and pull down. Notice how my handle is dropping as I come towards the base, because I want it pretty much flat across here. Again, a little roll of paint. And you can press pretty hard on this. Okay. And pull out some more paint. Now I want to do the other side of the front of the cabin. So my knife, it was like this. Now it's like this. Touch and pull. Roll a paint, because I didn't get enough on there. That's better. Go over it however many times it takes for you to get the proper amount on there. Okay, good. Now this peak here should actually be a little bit lower, because again, this cabin is, we're looking at it at somewhat of an angle. So I'll bring this down. Perfect. Okay, roll a paint. Now we're going to do this side. I'm going in and just come straight down. Now this is going to be just a simple cabin because I'm sure a lot of you are beginners out there, and so you don't want to get too complicated to start with. And there's a lot of YouTube stuff out there that you can look at to learn how to do cabins. Okay, I'm wiping off my knife. And what I want to do next is I want to make a few little boards. So what I'm going to do is take a little bit of burnt sienna and a little bit of white. Well, I'm sorry, I don't want to do the boards first. I want to do the highlighting first. So I've kind of marbled this just by pulling some white over the sienna. I'm going to do this side first because this is going to be the lightest side. So I come in, pretty good size roll of paint. I'm going to touch and come down. Oh, isn't that beautiful? Ooh, I love it. Okay, again, this time we're going to go this side. Oh, sweet. Very nice. Wipe the knife off. Now, because this is in shadow, your sun is here, so this is in shadow, so this would be just a slight bit darker. So in this case, I'll take some of the Van Dyke brown and just a little teeny bit of white. Whoop, a little bit more. There, see that marbling there? I hope you can see this. Pull. I'm going to start a little bit below the roof line here. Yeah, that's perfect. Because you want that in shadow. Very, very nice. Okay, now if you want to put boards in there, that's easy to do. On this front side, let's put a little more white in with this burnt sienna. There, see that marbling? That's pretty nice. Okay, a very thin roll. Notice that these boards, I do not make them exact distances apart. They are different. They're old rustic boards. Okay. Now for this side, I want a little bit darker. I'm going to put some of this dark brown in there. That's good. Okay. Well, that white's going to come through anyway. Well, that's fine. That'll work. However it works, you know, it just can be anything you want it to be. I say anyway a lot, don't I? That's all right. Okay, so now let's put in a little door. I want to change to a small knife because that is more appropriate for a small door. So let's put it on this side. Just a little bit here. Just scraping across, just taking off some of the surface paint. Good. And now with the short edge of the knife, this short edge, let's make a window right here. Perfect. Wipe the knife. Let's have two windows on this side. And notice it's it's a little bit slanted. Yep, you'll have a hard time seeing this part. Wipe. Oh, good. Okay. Now, for the door, let's take just plain dark Van Dyke brown, and on the small knife, a little roll of paint, and we're just going to darken this door. I notice I've deliberately left the roof till last. Wiping the knife off. Okay, now for the windows, I think blue, a little touch of blue, and I mean a little touch, and white. That's too much blue. I'm going to wipe the knife off and grab a little more white. Ah, that's perfect. That's perfect. Okay. Pull and cut across. So when I pull down and cut across like that, what that does is it cleans up the edge. Okay, just go in here and just barely touch the windows. That gives it kind of that glassy look. I like that. Wipe the knife, because you're picking up brown when you do this, so you don't want to contaminate your blue color. There's that. And one more. Oh, cute. Okay. And let's see, also I want to put, since this part would be in shadow, I want to switch back to the large knife. Okay, I have the large knife. Get a roll, and this will be very dark right here. Perfect. And we'll just wipe the knife, and we'll make just a little bit of a line on this other side. Good. Coming right along. Okay, and then if you would like, you can take a little bit of white, and let's do this brown here. All I want to do is kind of tint this so it's a real light brown, because it's going to outline your door, it's going to outline your windows. Teeny, teeny roll. Pull it out really flat. Teeny roll. Okay, just go across, touch. Teeny roll. Well, I haven't got enough. Even when you've been painting a long time, you know, you still make boo-boos. it's fun. It's all fun. And the more you do this, the more you learn. So now we hit the bottom. Down there. And how about a little bit on the sides here too? Good. Put a doorknob in if you want. Why not? Okay, now, excuse me. Let's see, the last thing is the roof. The roof is fun. Take some of the dark brown, and I've already got this here. It's a little bit of dark and white, and we'll take a little more. And some red. Red is beautiful. And I want to grab some white and put right over the top of that. This is marbling. I put those layers, 1, 2, 3, actually 4. Scoop, 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 and pull. That gives you that pretty marble. Wipe the knife. Okay, I'm going to grab a good size roll of paint, because this is a roof, it's large. So come up to the top here, touch and pull. Oh, cool. Okay, again. There. And if you want, you excuse me, you can highlight that, like this window color that we used. If you want, you can just highlight that roof a little bit more there. Oh, that's turned out nice. All these great little things happen when you're painting. I forgot one little step. I just remembered we still have this little part on the roof here to do. We didn't do that yet. So a roll of paint, and we're going to go here, here, here. There. That did it. And that's it for the cabin. This is just a brush I had used to put in the grass. But once you have this in, again, remember your sun is coming this way. So you would have shadow on this side. So let's just bring some shadow out. And I'm just touching the bottom of the cabin and pulling. And that puts it in shadow. Cool, huh? Yeah, okay. And that's it. If you want to, I would add maybe some evergreen trees, or maybe a tree here, and maybe just a tree here. That would look nice. You could put a pathway in. You could put some rocks and stones in. Just ad lib and do whatever you feel comfortable with doing. Well, cabins are tons of fun to do, and they make a really nice addition to any painting. So I hope you try them, and you can do these cabins with a brush as well as a knife. Basically, what I was just doing is showing you the steps. So anyway, have fun with it and paint lots of cabins and put them in your paintings. See you next month.